Hello students, today we will discuss a very interesting part of our biology, that is the viruses. So what are the structures and what are the, how they reproduce and other factors. So viruses, we know the term was first coined by Pasteur, Louis Pasteur, indicating something which is toxic. Clear? Something which is toxic. Later, Ivanovsky isolated TMB, discovered TMB, which is a virus. Then Bezhernik described virus as a contiguum vivum fluidum, that is something living contiguous fluid. And later on, Stanley first crystallized virus. Clear? Outside the, when it is outside the host body, Stanley first crystallized it. So through various steps we came to know about viruses. And now how can we define virus? It is a entity between living and non-living. Now why we are calling it an entity between living and non-living? Because certain characters of this virus are very similar to non-living. That means they can be crystallized. Clear? So crystallization is not a property of living organism. When in outside the host body, even they can be crystallized. Next, they don't have any proper cellular organization. We know that basic criteria for a living organism is to have a cellular organization, but that is absent in virus. Clear? Then they don't show any metabolism or anything, any life process outside the host body. Clear? So all these factors describe virus as a non-living agent, but still we are considering it as an entity between living and non-living, as because it has an organization which is made up of organic compound like nucleic acids, protein, all these are found in the living organisms. Inside host body, when it has a capability to infect a specific organism, and that also very specific, and inside the host body it can reproduce like that of the other organism, but it does not show any growth or homeostasis or other factors, but it can reproduce like that of the other organism. So we can't ignore it as a totally non-living, neither can we consider it as a totally living. So it is an entity between living and non-living, which has a central nucleic acid encircled by protein. Clear? And since they shows only life process, that is reproduction, and that occurs in the host body, so they are obligatory parasite. That means without that particular parasitic life, parasitic entity, clear, they cannot become, they cannot survive, so they or reproduce or grow. So they are not growth, cannot reproduce. Clear? So they are obligatory parasites. So let us go through the structure of the virus. So if we go on for the structure of virus, what we are going to see, first of all, it has a, not all but many of them has an envelope. Clear? Envelope, which is in this picture you are not seeing envelope, it is outside this covering. Clear? An envelope is present, which is loose covering, which is often made up of lipid, carbohydrates. Clear? Coming from the host cell. So host, this envelope is made up of, it is a loose covering made up of lipid, carbohydrates coming from the host cell, and sometimes proteins are also there, which generally may be from the virus. Now this envelope is made up of small subunits which are called pelpomere. certain viruses which have enveloped are like the herpes virus. Obviously, these are basically pathogenic viruses. Clear, and all viruses are somehow goes to other organisms. So they have like herpes virus. They have enveloped outside this covering. So here we are seeing a picture of a phage virus, and this outer covering in the phage virus is the capsid. So inside those virus having envelope, inside the envelope they have a proteinaceous covering which is called capsid. Clear? So proteinaceous coat which is called capsid, and this capsid is made up of small subunits called capsomere. Now capsid is made up of, so capsid, what is capsid? Capsid is absolutely a proteinaceous covering which is made up of small subunits called capsomere. Clear? It may be cuboidal like in phage virus, here you can see, or it may be helical. Clear? Like in TMV. Clear? So it may be helical like in TMV, or it may be cuboidal. This capsid may be cuboidal, that like of that of phage virus. Now inside the capsid, what we are going to see? Inside the capsid, we will find the nucleic acid. So inside the capsid, we will find the nucleic acid. Now this nucleic acid may vary. Clear? It's not that DNA is the nucleic acid always. Many of viruses have RNA as their nucleic acids, but never DNA, RNA both. They either they have DNA or they have RNA. Clear? So nucleic acid of virus may be made up of DNA or maybe it is RNA, but never both. And that DNA also may be double-stranded DNA. Clear? Like in herpes virus, or it may be single-stranded DNA like that in coliphage. That means the phage virus which affect the E. coli. Clear? So it may be double-stranded DNA like that of this bacteriophage or herpes virus, or it may be single-stranded DNA like that of the coliphage. And in certain viruses, clear, like you can see here the nucleic acid is RNA. Clear? So here the nucleic acid is RNA, and here also RNA may be double-stranded as in reovirus, or it may be like this one single-stranded RNA like that of TMV. So tobacco mosaic virus, it may have single-stranded DNA like that of tobacco mosaic virus, or it may have double-stranded DNA RNA. Clear? So it may have single-stranded RNA that like of the tobacco mosaic virus, or it may have double-stranded RNA that like of that reovirus. Now, generally, it is not that always the same, but generally these DNA viruses affect the animals. Clear? And these RNA viruses affect the plant. But it is not always true, as like others, here also exception is there, like HIV is an RNA virus, but it affects human being. Like lots of RNA viruses are there which affects human being and causes diseases. Again, cauliflower mosaic virus is a DNA virus which affects the plant. So though it is a very generalized thing that DNA viruses are animal virus, but it's not always true. Exceptions, lots of exceptions are there. So, and what else a virus can have? Apart from this, apart from protein, nucleic acid, another thing a virus may have, that is the enzyme. Not that all virus will possess enzyme, but certain viruses are there which possess enzyme, like phage virus. Phage virus contains lysozyme. Lysozyme, they use it for making pore in the bacterial cell wall. Clear? Lysozyme, this phage virus have lysozyme for making pore on the bacterial cell wall. The RNA viruses, all these RNA viruses, clear, they have reverse transcriptase for transforming RNA for forming RNA to DNA. So these RNA viruses have reverse transcriptase for forming RNA to DNA, because until and unless it forms DNA, it cannot get incorporated with the host cell. So they have to make DNA, and for this they have a particular enzyme called reverse transcriptase. So let us have a recap about the structure of virus. First of all, certain viruses have a outermost covering called envelope. Envelope is made up of lipids or carbohydrates which are produced from the host cell. Sometimes they are made up of, they contain protein also, and generally this protein is made from this virus. This envelope contains the subunits called pelpomeres. Certain viruses with envelope are herpes virus. Next is the capsid. Clear, this is present in all virus, so it is an integral part of the virus. Clear, so it contains a protein covering which is called capsid, and this capsid is made up of small subunits called capsomere, and this capsid may be cuboidal or it may be helical. Clear, like that of Hodge or that of herpes virus, that of TMB virus. And inside the capsid, there are nucleic acids, which may be DNA or RNA, but never both. Clear, when DNA, it may be single-stranded or double-stranded. When RNA also, it may be single-stranded or double-stranded. And certain viruses, in addition to this structure, they have enzymes like FAD. Or bacteria, the virus which infect bacteria contains lysozyme for making pore on the bacterial wall. The RNA viruses contains reverse transcriptase for forming DNA. So certain enzymes are also present. So nucleic acid and protein are the integral part, and apart from that, some may have envelope, some may have enzymes. So this is about the structure of virus. And about the host, viruses are host specific. They have specific host. It is not that the virus can go to any cell and infect there and multiply there. They have specific host. Specificity is there. So the viruses which infect plant are called phytophage. The viruses which infect animals are called zoophage. The viruses which infect bacteria are called bacteriophages. So phytophage like tobacco mosaic virus, zoophage like HIV, bacteriophage like T2 or T4 bacteriophage. Clear, all these are various viruses according to their hosts. Next is the reproduction. Now, we know that virus is can reproduce only within the living cell. Outside the living cell, it is absolutely like a dead particle, showing no life process, clear, and even may be crystallized. So how they reproduce within the host cell? Now, first of all, suppose this is bacteriophage. This is attacking a bacteria. So first phase is the infecting the bacteria, and it gets adhered on the bacterial cell wall. It releases lysozyme to make a pore on the bacterial cell wall. Then through this pore, it injects the genetic or nuclear material inside the bacterial cell. Clear? Inside the bacterial cell, this nuclear material now gets incorporated within the bacterial genome. Clear? So this is the bacterial genome. And this nucleic material of the viruses that gets incorporated into the bacterial genome. If it is DNA, it will directly get incorporated. If it is RNA, it will be by reverse transcription, it will produce DNA, and that DNA will get incorporated. But somehow the viral genetic material will get incorporated with the bacterial into the bacterial DNA genome. Clear? And now at this stage, it may go for two types of, the fate may be of two types.
One is the lysogenic cycle. Lysogenic cycle, the lambda phages. Here, lambda phages, they undergoes lysogenic cycle. What happens in that? They just remain dormant at, they get integrated with the bacterial genome, but remain dormant as such. Bacteria now may divide and form numerous bacterial cell where the genome is integrated with viral DNA. So with viral DNA, the bacteria now may reproduce and form numerous, with this viral material, the bacteria now may reproduce and produce numerous bacteria, where in each bacteria we will get that viral DNA. And but this viral DNA is totally dormant here, and because there are certain proteins which inhibits the activity of the viral DNA, so it remains dormant. But when such proteins are not there, then only this viral DNA becomes active and starts dividing, forming new viruses. So this type of phase where this viral DNA becomes dormant, remain as such for certain bacterial generations, and then may become active, this is called lysogenic cycle, which we find in the lambda phages. But other group, what we find that just after getting incorporated into the bacterial DNA, now they regulate the bacterial activity of the bacterial DNA. Here they regulate the activity of the bacterial DNA, and they produce numerous viral proteins and nucleic acids. Clear, these proteins and nucleic acids assemble themselves for form numerous virus, and finally they destroy the cells and comes out. By the destroying the cells, this is called by lysis of the cell. That means breaking down of the cell. So this is called lytic cycle. Clear? And this will again infect a new bacteria. So in lytic cycle, what happens? First of all, bacteria gets adhered to its host. Virus get adheres to its host bacteria. Clear? Adheres, then releases lysozyme. Makes pore on the wall of the bacteria. It injects the nucleic acids into the bacterial cell. The nucleic acid get incorporated in the bacterial genome. This viral DNA now controls the bacterial genome and produces numerous viral material, nucleic acids and protein. They reassemble themselves, forming numerous virus, and finally by the lysis of the bacterial cell, they comes out. Clear? And destroying the bacterial cell. So this is called lytic cycle. So these all are phagic reproduction, which may be lytic cycle or lysogenic cycle. Clear? In lysogenic cycle, it is not destroying the bacterial cell immediately, but in lytic cycle, immediately it will become active and it will destroy the bacterial cell. Okay. Thank you. Another thing I want to tell, that sometimes the viruses also reproduces by pinocytosis, or in some cases the virus may be directly taken, the whole virus may be taken within the cell, and then they may reproduce there. So various processes are there, but mostly lytic and phage, lysogenic phage, these are very common ones.